If the 16th term of a geometric sequence is 1024 and the common ratio is 2, we want to find the sequence formula and the first three terms. So because we're told this is a geometric sequence, we know the sequence formula must be in the form of a sub n equals a sub 1 times r raised to the power of n minus 1. So now if we go back and look at the given information, we're told the 16th term of the sequence is 1024, which means a sub 16 must equal 1024. We're also told the common ratio r is equal to 2. And now we'll use this information to perform substitution into our sequence formula. If we let a sub n be equal to a sub 16, we can substitute 1024 for a sub n, as long as we substitute 16 for n. So we'd have 1024 equals a sub 1 times r, which we know is 2, raised to the power of n minus 1, where again n is equal to 16. So we have 16 minus 1 as our exponent. So we have 1024 equals, this would be a sub 1 times 2 to the 15th. So now to solve for a sub 1, we'll divide both sides by 2 raised to the power of 15. When we do this, we'll get the first term, but we'll also have enough information to write our sequence formula. This would simplify to 1, so we have a sub 1 equals this quotient here. Let's go ahead and use our calculator. We have 1024 divided by 2 raised to the power of 15. Let's go and convert this to a fraction. So a sub 1 is equal to 1/32, which means our formula for the sequence must be a sub n equals a sub 1, which we just found to be 1/32, times r, which we know is 2, raised to the n minus 1 power. Now I realize we could change the form of this since 32 is equal to 2 to the 5th, but let's go ahead and leave it like this. So here's the sequence formula. Here's the first term, but we're also asked to find the next two terms. So we could use a sub 1 and multiply by the common ratio to find the second and third term, but let's go ahead and practice using our formula. So our second term, a sub 2, is going to be equal to 1/32 times 2 to the 2 minus 1 power, first power. This would be 2/32, or 1/16. And then for a sub 3, our third term, we'd have 1/32 times 2 raised to the power of 3 minus 1, or the second power. 2 squared is 4, so we'd have 4/32, which simplifies to 1/8. So again, here's the formula for our sequence. And the first three terms would be 1/32, 1/16, and 1/8. Of course, the sequence would continue, but this is what the question asked for. Now that we have the sequence as a list, notice how the pattern here to find consecutive terms is to multiply by 2, our common ratio. Okay, I hope you found this explanation helpful.